are you, Mr. Mandel?
Oh, great. Got my alligator shirt on. How are you doing?
Oh, me? Oh, I'm fine, except for my arthritis. When it flares up, what pain. You can't believe it. It started with my right foot. I thought it was a bunion. But then when it moved to my hand, this fatty part, I thought, I can't have a bunion on my hand. And then it went into my wrist. Kind of better now. Mm-hmm. But, oh, it's still bad in my elbow and my left shoulder. Oh, my. What pain? No one knows. No one knows. Oh, it's kind of going into my chest. Hope it's just arthritis. Oh, painful when I take a breath. I better check with the doctor. I wonder if Mary will relieve me for my break. Arthritis? Or is that my rib, or is that my... Oh, dear.
I'm gonna be a really big star and all these children are gonna get paid. Hey, Bozo, how you doing? You should have been at the market. You know what happened in the market? A guy, listen to this, okay? A guy comes into the market and he's blind and he's got one of those seeing eye dogs, so he picks up the dog by the tail and he starts swinging it around. And the manager walks up to him and says, "What are you doing?" So he says, "I'm just looking around." Well, you don't get it. You're just a cat. It's a dog joke. You would get it. Hello? Hello? Hello?
Howie, is that you?
Yeah, who's that?
It's Sandy from the Comedy Store. Listen, you're on tonight. You didn't forget, did you?
Of course not. I wouldn't forget. I got new material to do tonight and everything. I'm really looking forward to it.
Okay. Then we'll see you on stage here at 8.
Yeah, okay, Sandy. All right, I'll talk to you later. Looking forward to it. Bye.
She'll be coming around the mountain, she'll be coming around the mountain, she'll be coming around the mountain. riding big white horses when she comes. She'll be riding big white horses when she comes. She'll be riding big white horses. She'll be riding big white horses. She'll be riding big white horses when she comes.
So good when I stay up. No.
Howie Mandel, that new expiring comedian?
Yeah, you heard of me, huh?
Okay, buddy, get in and don't ask no questions.
Who? Me? No. Me? Hey, wait a minute. I know there's a mistake here. You're looking for another comic. That's it. I know what it is. It wasn't me. It's another guy. I gotta go to a show. That's. Have you heard the one about the? You probably heard the one about.
Hello, kid. You take it easy. Nothing's gonna happen.
Oh, you guys had me worried. I was scared there for a minute.
Shut up! Just listen to what we have to say.
Now look, all we want you to do is to take this envelope.
If you wanted me to mail a letter, you just could have told me. You didn't have to go through this trouble. Take me to a mailbox and
I said shut up! Now we're gonna drop you off at the Comedy Store. You're gonna perform as scheduled.
You guys had me worried. I didn't think you were gonna let me perform. Thanks a lot, you guys. Give me a lift.
Finish, will ya? There'll be some minor changes in your show tonight. We wrote you some new material.
Wait, you guys don't understand. I write my own material, so get yourself another comic, okay, guys? So I'll see you all a little bit later.
You don't understand. Now you listen, and you listen good. You'll do as we say, or you'll die right on stage. And not just for bad material, either. You see, our contacts, Rocky and his boys, will be in the audience tonight. They'll be listening very closely to that secret message we've hidden in your act. It's gonna tell them when, where, and how the new shipment of drugs will be coming in, so all you gotta do is read the message.
Yeah, but why me?
Because you're safe. And we can't afford to take any more chances. Our phones have been tapped. And we've been tailed by the AFI before.
The FBI, dummy.
Yeah, the FBI. And then, do you get the picture? I mean,
not exactly. I don't...
Look. You see, nobody in a million years would ever expect a goofball comedian like you to get up in front of a live audience and spout all these secrets to another gang. You understand? That's clever, right?
Yeah, you guys are pretty clever, but what if I decide not to cooperate, huh?
Stand in line at the bank for a really long time, and when you finally get up to the window, just ask for change of a nickel. They actually call other tellers over to look at you. Come here. Come here. Come. Run into an ordinary store and say,
are you open on Thursdays?
They say, yes. Say,
thank you.
And run. Let them figure it out. And certainly none of your concern. Now, some of these are a little more practical than others. If you're in a bar and someone says, hey, can I buy you a drink? Say, no, thanks, but can I have the money instead, please? Tell them you're saving up to buy a bar. Same with coffee. Everybody wants you to have a cup of coffee. You notice that everywhere you go, people offer you a cup of coffee. If you were to accept all the coffee that's been offered to you, you'd be one of the Hills brothers by this time. Everywhere you go to their house, you go to their office, say, do you want some coffee? I say, no, thanks, I have some at home. However, we could use a little flour. Should get something you need. Don't need coffee, have a list ready. Got any cup of soup? Give me a pound of plums and a roll of saran wrap and I'll be on my way. Hey, he's your friend. He's trying to help you. Help him help you. Tell him what you need at home. Thank you so much for your attention tonight and for your laughter. Love you all. See you another time. Bye-bye.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. George Carlin. Yeah, I've been working here for quite some time, and I've been watching that boy, and he's going to make a real big one these days. Anyway, we have another special guest for you who needs no introduction, so I ain't going to give him one.
You could have said my name or something. Okay, I'm a little bit, thanks everybody, I'm a little bit nervous tonight, I am, because on the way here, I got kidnapped, and the guys, you know what they did, they stole my jokes, they stole them, and I'm also crazy, because I've been on the road for 3 months now, and I hate performing on the road, because the cars drive by, and they splash up, so from now on, I'm going to perform inside. Okay, you know what I'll do, I'll do an impression, here, I do everything, okay, here's an impression, this is my impression of a Mexican without a car. I hope they're not here, Mexican. Okay, I'll do, here's something, I'll do this. My pecker.
listen, we're here for the stuff.
I'm sorry, you'll have to wait in line like everybody else.
Listen, I'm Roxy. I'm here for the stuff.
You want a leg or a breast?
Everybody wants to be a comedian. Now cut out the jokes! Pick it up around the back. Hurry it up, huh? We got all night. Gotta be across the border by midnight. Count it.